Start.
Welcome, Dr. Kafir Khan, to University Collective's talk series that is named The Fight for Justice Must Go On.
Okay. Fine.
Thank you. Thank you, Mirdala, and thank you, University Collective, for giving me this opportunity to explain me what me and my family is going for the past 3 years. I would call it a roller coaster ride. But the support the people have given me from all over India, all 138 crore people, and even in, from abroad, especially Gulf, US, UK, Canada, and Australia, South Africa. So it was amazing, and especially the support I got from Keralaite people. I still remember after releasing from jail for the first time after BRD auction tragedy, I visited to Kerala, and I was it was amazing experience for me. The love and affection they showered me, I knew about my case. And then I visited, and 4-5 times I visited in 1.5 years before I sent behind the bar again. It was really the amazing experience, because everyone, wherever I go, the Malappuram, Kochi, Kottayam, everywhere people were so happy to see me, and they knew about my family history and everything. So, and even they offered me to come down and settle in Kerala. And Medulla, if you remember, we did a camp in a medical camp even in Wayanad after the flood came.
Yeah.
So thank you everyone for all the support.
So the first thing is, after the BRD Medical College oxygen tragedy, you are more of a doctor.
Yes.
It is a fact that without much support from the medical fraternity and from the opposition parties, you have conducted around 150 or more than that medical camps for children from underprivileged states and communities. So after that, you were again jailed for intervening to diagnose the mysterious disease in Mumbai Hospital, and which again led to 2.5 months of detention. And can you tell us about this period of time? I mean, the activism you have done, which led to many important exposes.
See, Amadla, before the BRD auction tragedy, I was just a common doctor who used to go to hospital and come back and spend time with the family. During my incarceration of 9 months in after the BRD auction tragedy, I realized when you are punished for doing some good work, when you are a doctor and you are from a good family and you have so many people support, still you can be punished for doing something, saving child. So what is happening all over India? So when I came out of the jail, people are calling me, and I started touring all over India and meeting people and, talking to them. And I met so many activists, and I realized there's so many things happening in India. Instead of the basic issue of roti, kapda, makan, health, education, and employment, for the past 6, 10, 8 years, there are so many things happening which should not happen. In the name of religion, caste, socioeconomic status, people are getting divided. So, and then I realized when I did the medical camp you have talked about, I did medical camp all over in the India, and we have treated more than 50,000 kids. And I realized the BRD oxygen tragedy was just a brutal face of our broken health system. So we started doing work for health for all campaign. We started in 2018, 19, January from Hyderabad. And I met almost 13 chief minister and submitted this proposal to the health minister, Dr. Harshvardhan, July 2019. And in that, we demanded that there should be health facility for each and every individual, whether it's any caste, any religion, any region, any socioeconomic status. So you are right that the activism came to me, and I'm more like more than a doctor, because I realized that there are so many things which is happening in India which should not happen. And instead of talking about the main basic issues, they're talking about Ram Mandir, they're talking about the Shamshan Kabristan, they're talking about Ali Bajrang Bali, they're talking about Teen Talaq, Halala, CAA, NRC. So there are so many things. As a doctor, as a human being, as a Indian, I think I can't close my eyes and see injustice happening in front of me. It is not only my responsibility. I think every responsible citizen of India would not see happening things which can break our India, which can, you know, when our democracy in danger, when our constitution is in danger. I still remember when we went to Wayanad in that Adivasi area, in that Dalit area, I would call it. There was no place to shit, you know. People, there were so many tuberculosis cases. Nobody wanted to go to that place. There was no health facility at all. And those people were still living like they are living in a pre-independent area. So what is the meaning of getting independence? I think for them, like, it's already 75 years, 73 years of independence, but still they are living in a miserly condition. So we have to talk about them.
Yeah, these things, only these things were you saying in the Aligarh speech, right?
Yes, yes.
So for that.
Yes, I was talking. This is a landmark judgment, I would call it. And even though it came late after 7 months, but I'm still really grateful to the judiciary, especially the Chief Justice of Supreme Court and the Chief Justice of Allahabad High Court. Which he said that it's a freedom of speech given by the constitution. And if you read this 42 pages of order, which is delivered by Chief Justice Honorable Govind Mathur on 1st of September, which is clearly said that since on the first page itself, it is written that since BID oxygen tragedy to August 2017, the government sponsored victimization is happening not only to the detainee, actually he's talking about me, to Dr. Kafil, and to the whole family. And he has agreed in 4 points. I will talk about the justice or the whole thing. He has summarized. I will summarize. First thing he has said that it is very surprising. It is very surprising that district magistrate of Aligarh has selectively chosen those words from the my speech of 30 to 45 minutes and put it and concocted it as like a hate speech of hatred and violence. And he has said not a iota of any hint is there, any indication is there which can indicate and which can say that this is a speech of hatred and violence. Instead, the whole speech is about the integrity and unity of the Indian citizens. And he has said that Dr. Kafil has talked about the population, pollution, education, health, and about unemployment, economy. So he said it is that the what DM has done is selectively chosen the words and made it like that, and no responsible person can do that. Even he has. He has pointed out that it's very surprising that even after securing bail on 10th of February 2020 for the alleged speech, I was slapped National Security Act, and that also after 4 days of delay, illegal detention. And he was surprised to see that a police inspector has written a letter to the SP City. SP City has written a letter to the SSP, the senior superintendent of police of the Aligarh, and the senior superintendent of police has written letter to the district magistrate of Aligarh. All four people has written the same format, same language, and same charges on me on for NSA. And he was surprised that it was looked like they are sitting in the same room. So he called the whole procedure illegal. And you know, in National Security Act, it is for the anti-national people and for the those terrorist organization, not for the common people. You know, this act and they put it me this act and called it illegal. And this NSA is for 3 months, and every 3 months you have to extend, giving a new evidence, a fresh evidence. They have to show that I have to detain this person, and every three extension with me, and every extension they have talked about that if Dr. Kapil will come out, he will create a, it will be a law and order situation. Honorable Justice has surprised that in during lockdown, the whole India was locked down in March, May, and April, and the whole country is struggling with the pandemic. This doctor was jailed and giving this one explanation that he will come out and create a problem for law and order. So he is not only called my NSA illegal, he quashed all three extension also.
Yeah, I think the most important point the judgment made is that how the district administration and the police officials combine their works to put you in again in jail after receiving an order from the same court, which again now has issued another judgment and which already had given you bail in the case, right? Yeah. So you were asked in the jail that not to say anything against the government. Similarly, you were given a second suspension in the September 2019 after the inquiry committee gave you a clean chit, right? So it was following up this model all through the cases.
Murtala, I'm already suspended for the 3 years. Even after getting a clean chit by the inquiry committee, they continued my suspension. And not only the jail authority, when the special task force has picked me from the Mumbai airport, and they kept themselves with themselves for the next 72 hours and delivered to me to the Mathura prison only on first February early morning, or you can call 31st night, you know. So for 72 hours they tortured me like anything. They beaten me, they made me naked, they slapped me, they didn't give me food, they didn't give me water to drink. So it was not only the mental torture, it was a physical torture this time. And then those STF people were asking me so many weird questions like, have you gone to abroad to destabilize the government? I said, my passport is in under judicial custody. How I would go to abroad? And have you invented some powder to kill millions of people? I was like, I am a doctor. I am doing medical camp. Where I will go? Where is my lab? And where I can create a powder to kill millions of people? So all those weird accusations they were making. And they also hinted that don't talk about 70 kids who died in the BRD Middle College. Don't talk about the CANRC. Don't talk about the government policies. During my stint in jail, the first 4-5 days was horrible. They kept me in a solitary confinement in a small cell. And they didn't give me food for 3-4-5 days. And they gave me only 2 chapati when I really begged and I started shouting and screaming, and it was my whole, you know, abdomen was cramping, and I was screaming like a mad person. You know, I can see food in the air. You know, chicken, mutton, and I can see the pastries and chapatis. So it was horrible. when my family moved to the court and they allowed to meet me, then only like I got some relief. Even though the jail condition was very horrible, the next 7.5 months was very horrible.
And you had written around 3 to 4 letters from jail, right? You mentioned about how the COVID condition is getting worse and how we India will face the catastrophe of outbreak if uncontrolled, right?
And yes.
Can you?
See, I made a video on 27th of January 2020 before my arrest on my YouTube channel. And you know, Mirdula, I used to talk about the health issues, and I have a channel on YouTube, Dr. Kafil Khan official channel, which I used to talk about the children's problem and how parents can tackle. So when I heard about the coronavirus coronavirus is killing people in China, I made a video and I had this thing that it will come in India, because the health system is broken in India, especially in North India. South India is a lot better, you know. Last time when Nipah virus came in Kerala, you remember? So I thought like it will come in India, it will create a havoc. That's why I made the video and I clearly said what you should do and what you should not do about the coronavirus. And unfortunately, I was arrested on 29th after 2 days of that video. From the jail itself, I have written a letter to Prime Minister, Honorable Prime Minister, on 19th of March. And in that, I have clearly, in 2-page letter, I have written everything about the coronavirus. And I requested him that I want to work as a corona warrior. And I told him that because of the broken health system and because 72% of population have no health facility actually in India. So if it has come that it is very and very populated places, that's what the whole India, especially the North India. So if once it will come, it will be very difficult to control the third stage. And it is imminent to that we would enter into the community transmission stage, even though government is still denying that we are not in the community transmission stage, and we have already crossed 4 million. Yes, and 70,000 people have been died, you know. So I have written to the Chief Minister also about that, and to the public about that, that the coronavirus, how to save themselves. After coming out of jail, I'm going to write to the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, Yogi Adityanath Ji Maharaj, that give my service back or terminate me. I can go to the join in any other hospital, and I want to work as a corona warrior. Maybe I can do some research in the medicine field, and we can help. I can put myself as a volunteer for the vaccine research.
Yeah, since you already worked in the field of an epidemic, right?
Yes, that's what. And if they won't allow, I would go to the flood affected areas of Bihar, Assam, and even I want to come to Kerala also.
Okay, can you tell us how this now we have almost all the jails of the country as overcrowded, and at the same time they are having several more than hundreds of COVID patients, right? And can you tell us how the jail authorities are taking care or handling the case of pandemic outbreak inside the jail?
That is not possible actually. If in the jail you can control a pandemic, but jail is so crowded. In UP, the total capacity of the total jail capacity of the Uttar Pradesh 71 prison is around 72,000 to 74,000, and already 1.5 lakh prisoners are there. Even in Mathura jail where I was lodged, the total capacity of the jail was 554 in prisons prisoners, and there were 1600 inmates were there. So it was not possible to separate then, and the social distancing norm was a distant dream. Washing hands every half an hour, 2 hours. It's not possible. And wearing mask in a suffocating stuff. We were out in a barrack of where 50 people were supposed to be there. There were 150 people, and there was only one toilet, you know. And most of the time we are in that barrack in 16 hours, in 24 hours. And though that suffocating environment where people are sneezing, farting, coughing, you know, so it was not possible. When this coronavirus, COVID came to the Mathura jail, already 54 inmates are already infected. So it is very difficult for the jail authority to control the outbreak. They have made some temporary jail outside the prison, and they can keep the new prisoners in that prison. And when they come negative, they bring it inside. But it's still that corona, you can't control the jail police and the jail official to go out. So when they come inside and food comes inside, so that brings corona. Even in my barrack, you know, two person was corona positive. Luckily, when I got released, they did the test and I got negative.
Okay. Yeah, there was reports about that. And after the release in 2018, you were still termed as the accused in Gorakhpur oxygen tragedy in the media headlines. So it took almost 2 years or 2.5 years to get that adjective out from your name, and doctor, it became just Dr. Kapil Khan. So there were a lot of misreporting happening in your case whenever you got arrested, whenever you were taken to illegal custody. There were reports that you are released in bail. So there was a lot of misreporting happening. And how do you see that role of media in your case?
See, the true journalism is still alive. People like you are there, and print, and so many digital media. But the television media and the print media, I would say, not all, but most of them has become, you know, really biased, and I think maybe influenced by the government. Because I still remember when I was sent to BRD Oxygen after BRD Oxygen tragedy, they called me murderer, Sattar Bachcho Katil, and they made me hero and they made me villain also. And even after I got acquitted, bail from Allahabad High Court stating that there is no evidence of medical negligence, there is no evidence of corruption, there is no evidence of that he was involved with the oxygen tender. And even after I got the clean sheet, still they called me, you know, the controversial Dr. Kapil Khan, you know, when I read the headlines. So I still remember the Arnav Goswami calling me, you know, this Sattar Bachcho Katil, India TV, Rajat Sharma, like so many people, you know. So there are bias, but there are still true journalism is still alive. I think it's like even in India, the whole India is getting divided on the basis of caste and religion and socioeconomic status. That's worried. Everyone should be worried about. It's not only me. Everybody should come up and stand up and speak up.
Okay.
See, even after this time, when I got released, so many media houses has called me for interviews, and they asked me my views and everything, and why you are jail, and why Uttar Pradesh government is continuing this witch hunt, why this one person is behind one person. But nobody dare to ask the Uttar Pradesh government that why they are treating me or my family. If you remember, my brother was shot within a kilometer where the chief minister was there. And even after 2 years, no arrest, no investigation, no charge sheet, and nobody is daring to ask him and who tried to kill my brother. So the media never questioned the real persons also. but still I would call it like some people are still there. Avish Kumar sir is there, Abhishar Sharma is there, and people are there to who speak up.
Your case itself is an indicator to the India's health condition, India's healthcare condition as such, and it was an indicator, it was an alarm to many people, many political groups to get up and know what really happening. And the project that Health for All, which is followed by this case, and you approached several bureaucrats, several politicians, several ministers. So how was this responded at?
Even I met the Union Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan, and we gave them this Health for All proposal. The Health for All proposal is not only my work. There were 25 eminent persons from all over the India and from a different field. Some senior Supreme Court lawyers, some best doctors of India, some are CEOs, some are technicians, some are really good social workers. So we got the data from United Nations, UNICEF, World Bank, WHO, and we got to surprise when in BRD when 70 kids died the same year in 2017. 8.2 lakh kids died all over India, and in 2018 WHO says that 8.8 lakh kids died in India. That means every hour 100 kids are dying in India. 4.5 lakh people are dying because of tuberculosis, when tuberculosis is disappearing from all over India. India has become third largest country with HIV AIDS people. India has become second largest country with diabetic people. 72% of our population don't have health facility. One doctor has a responsibility to see 51,000 people in rural areas. So these are the data we have, and then we made the solution also. We gave them that thing. So we have the data, and we made this proposal, and we gave it to them. But still, I think if they would have agreed and they would have listened and they would have gone through those data, even though they are sure that they will do it and they will look into it and they will try to improve the health system. But if they would have gone through that and if they would have implemented at least few points, that our demand was at least spend 3% of GDP on health expenditure, I think we would be better prepared for this pandemic, coronavirus. Now 70,000 people have died. Even one death is really miserable for the whole family. And we can't get away with by stating that no, only 73,000 people have died, and all over the world. See, in US, 1.8 lakh people have died. See, in Brazil, so many people die. See. So we can't compare like that. You know, India has a population of 138 crore people. So we can't compare the data And India has become second largest country in the world who was affected with coronavirus. And winter is coming. I'm telling you, that time from the jail, my estimate was 30 to 40 lakh. And we have already crossed 4 million. And now my estimate is by the time December comes and this winter comes, because in the winter, the kids who I call them super spreader, because they don't get affected with the disease much, but they will spread the virus to the people, elderly people. They will get affected during winter, and they will be the one super spreader. And we have to be very careful during winter season. So my estimate is we are going to cross more than 10 million by December.
Okay. By the nature of this virus, it is going to be a widespread thing.
Yeah, until vaccine comes, there is no solution. There is no medicine as such. Whatever we talk about, remdesivir and or Fabiflu and whatever hydroxychloroquine, oxygen we are giving, but it's still we don't have any medicine as such, and So we have to wait for the vaccine to come, and I don't think so vaccine is coming within next 1 year. Even though Russia is claiming that they have the vaccine and they started giving to their people, but I think by the time India will get, and by the time the real vaccine comes, which gives the immunity for long, it will take time.
Okay. So, do you still have an expectation that that your team can expect from these government or the parliamentarians?
See, we should work, and we should not worry about the results. Our team is still working, and right now I'm just with my family, spending time with my family, because that 7.5 months was not only the mental toll, the financial, and very difficult for the whole family. So I'm just spending time with my family, and we want to come out with this mental trauma, and then I will start my work again. Yeah. There is so many rumors that I have joined Congress, I have left Uttar Pradesh, and I'm scared of going back to Uttar Pradesh. I want to tell people, and I want to assure everyone, to my friends and well-wishers and everyone who has supported me in this fight, that through your media, that I'm not running away. I won't bend. I'm not leaving Uttar Pradesh. I have not joined politics. I am happy to be a doctor, and I would continue to be as a doctor.
Okay. So now with the pandemic, the anti-CA protests which were in the heights of its intensity got halted in the offline sense, but the protests are going on online. But and the protests were followed by this violence in Delhi that killed almost more than 50 people, 50 Muslims in the northeast Delhi. So after that, a lot of anti-CA protesters are arrested. Even before that, it started. So
still more than 200 students are behind the bar, and still more than 200 students are behind the bar for this anti-CA protest from Jamia and JNU and Aligarh. All those universities from all over India, and it is that's what the fascist forces do. They suppress the voice, but we'll continue that. And right now the whole country is facing a one really major issue, and we have to be united together to fight this coronavirus pandemic, and we have to be concentrated on that. They are also not talking, those people who talked about the chronology of CA, and then NPR will come, and then NRC will come. Those people are also not talking about NRC now. So we will wait. But if they come out with that idea again, then we'll protest again. We'll speak up again.
Yeah, there is one more thing that we want to know, that in the Madura jail where you were jailed, or in previous arrests as well, the prisoners whom you were with, can you tell us how which communities do they belong, and if that is possible, you can.
It was from all communities, but I would call it most of the form, like from Dalit community, minorities, most of them. Those prisoners was very helpful to me, and then I think they knew my story, and they never during my 9 months of that instinct, and this month also 7.5 months, they never misbehaved with me. Actually, they helped with me for some other way, sometimes offering food, sometimes helping me. So but the thing is that if you are going to that, which community the government is targeting, you know that. out of 150 NSA in Uttar Pradesh government has put this year, I was the only lucky one who has got relief from the code, but still most of the people who have been slapped with NSA, half of the people was charged with the cow slaughtering, you know, and they
yeah.
put NSA on that.
Mm.
So, you know which community they are targeting and why they are targeting. It's just a politics and just a vote bank politics, you know. They want to scar the minds of youth. And I will tell you, this scar is going to heal. It will take decades to heal. Because, see, the nationalism and pseudo-nationalism, the fight for the right to speak and right to equality is going on the pre-independence area also and the independence area. This after we got the independence, some people are still living in a miserly condition and they don't have the vision. But Baba Sahab Ambedkar has seen when he written the constitution, it's still the rights. The rights are not actually given in the mint that they should have received. People are still suppressed and people are still living in a pathetic condition and they can't raise the voice. 90% of law is governed by the local police station. They whatever the inspector will say, that has become law, you know. Few people have the opportunity to move to lower court, to the high court, to the Supreme Court. You know, my family, how they run and they go to the high court and Supreme Court, they only know. But I am the lucky one who had the opportunity to go to Supreme Court to say that, see, 14 adjournment had happened for this, you know. Yeah. For me, this time also 14 time. And so many judges, they rescued themselves to hear my file. They were not, ready to listen even. So I have to move to the Supreme Court, and in Supreme Court, 1 lakh take around 2.5 lakh rupees to stand, 5 lakh rupees, you know. So people don't have money. So how we will get justice? The vision our Baba Sahab has seen is not actually delivered to the, I would call it, the most affected people and the most affected the community.
And even the constitution,
if you remember,
amended.
Many times they have amended the constitution. If you remember the 1932 Pune Act, after the our Mahatma Gandhi has intervened, you know, Baba Sahab has a vision that even after 100 years, we won't get the right, you know, what we are asking for. So he was not ready for the Pune Act, and that's a history.
Yeah. Thing that you specifically want to tell. Hello.
I just want to thank everyone who has supported me in this difficult time and supported me, me and my whole family. I want to assure you, everyone who given me so much love and affection, that Dr. Kafil Khan is not going to bend. Dr. Kafil Khan has not run away from Uttar Pradesh. And Dr. Kafil Khan will continue speaking any injustice done to anyone, anywhere.
Okay, I didn't...
You.
1 minute. I didn't really ask the question fully. That is there anything that you have to tell to the youngsters in the medical field and youngsters in the journalism?
I will call it to the youths. Remember that one thing is there, that don't get scared to speak truth. The more you get scared, they will scare you more. That's what fascist forces do. Remember one thing, that you speak from your heart and answer, you have to answer your heart. People ask me where you get the courage to speak up again and again after getting crushed and the whole family has to go through this, still you speaking up. I tell people, because of you only, the love and affection you give. And the thing is that, but I believe in myself that I have not done anything wrong. And, you know, I can see anyone in their eyes and tell that I have not done anything wrong. Remember one thing, that nationalism comes like a religion since birth. I am a Muslim because I got birth in a Muslim family, and then I believe, then I grow up, and I got, have had a belief that I love Allah, you know. I believe in Allah because that's my personal choice. There should not be any discrimination between the community and in the name of caste and religion. So come, get over with that. And the same thing is for the nationalism. I got born in India and I started loving India the day I born. So many people have offered, come to US, come to Canada, come to here. But I have not left my country because I want to work here. And so whatever you do, if your heart is saying it's wrong, should not do. Whatever you do, your heart is saying that you should do, do it. Don't get scared. Be brave and speak up.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much for speaking.
Thank you, Mridula.